Another round of fuel price hikes looming next week. The Energy Department estimates the price of gasoline will go up by 80 centavos, up to 1 peso and 15 centavos per liter. While diesel could see as much as 185 per liter jump, kerosene by as much as 1 peso and 10 centavos per liter. The agency cites as reasons for the uptick the Middle East conflict and rising demand for petroleum products as indicated in the outlook of the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries, or OPEC. Overall, since January this year, for those who are keeping count, gasoline has already seen a net increase of around 7 pesos per liter, diesel by a little over 6, and kerosene by less than 1 peso. There's over 2,800 jobs up for grabs as the health department holds a job fair as part of its 126th anniversary celebration. The DOH says from June 18, it has already received about 900 applications across the country. That number is expected to increase as the fair continues this week. The agency aims to recruit more workforce across its 76 operating units. Interested applicants are encouraged to attend the job fair in person, but they can also apply online through vacant positions posted on the Civil Service Commission website. The DOH eJobs for Health website and other designated platforms. Now, earlier, the agency admitted the lack of healthcare workers is among the major roadblocks to achieving its goal for Filipinos to be among the healthiest in Asia by 2040. The Philippine Agriculture Department vows to implement measures to prevent the hoarding of cheaper rice sold at Kadiwa stores across the country. Now, for context, the NFA launched a program that allows the selling of its aging rice stock at a price of 29 pesos per kilo to help Filipinos have access to the staple grain. The program is currently in its dry run phase and will be fully implemented next month. The Department of Agriculture says it will ensure that no family buys more than 10 kilos of that rice per month. A community in Quezon City turns to bamboo to push for sustainable housing solutions with the help of a nonprofit organization. Izzy Lee tells us all about that in this report.
At first glance, these houses look like regular homes. But would you believe they are made of bamboo? This community is located in Barangay Bagong Silangan, Quezon City. Rosita's family has been living here for 4 years. Even in the heat, they feel comfortable thanks to the materials used for their home. They also stand by its durability.
Nung dumaan ng mga bagyo at saka yung lindol, parang umuuga ng kunti lang. Pero hindi kagaya doon, Diyos ko, nangangamba ka talaga. Ang bamboo kasi flexible eh. Pagkakatiwalaan talaga sa tibay.
Behind the houses is Base Bahay Foundation, which built the houses in partnership with the Vincentian Foundation and provided them for free to the elderly and families with children who have special needs. Established by the Hilti Foundation 10 years ago, Base Bahay aims to provide alternative building solutions that meet the needs of local communities while addressing housing shortages and climate resilience. The housing relies on cement bamboo frame technology using treated bamboo reinforced with cement mortar as the structure's foundation. This technology allows for the construction of houses within 3 to 4 weeks.
If you look at the bamboo poles, may mga fibers yun na longitudinal. If I'm going to take one of the fibers sa bamboo and test it for tensile strength, the tensile strength is even stronger than steel. So yung fibers within the bamboo are very strong material.
By using locally grown and renewable materials such as bamboo, Base Bahay also hopes to offer a sustainable solution to the housing crisis, especially in areas prone to natural calamities.
Sa dami ng sakuna na nangyayari sa Pilipinas, importante na yung bahay resilient sa disasters. So itong technology na to ay resilient sa typhoons, so earthquakes, and all designed within the National Structural Code of the Philippines. So,
Base Bahay says the bamboo they use is of structural grade and were properly treated to resist pests. With proper maintenance, it can last for up to 50 to 100 years. The foundation has already established 6 supply facilities, sourcing bamboo from local farmers and creating jobs in bamboo treatment facilities. Base Bahay collaborates with various partners, including public and private foundations, contractors, and builders to share expertise in cement bamboo frame technology. Their project span multiple locations such as Tacloban, Basay Samar, Tondo, Manila, Davao del Norte, and many more. A significant challenge that Base Bahay faces is changing the perceptions of bamboo.
Kailangan din namin i-educate or palitan yung paniniwala na ang kawayan eh material ng mahirap. If it's used to its fullest potential, malakas ang kawayan as a material. Kaya a lot of our resources are also focused on research and innovations.
It's a challenge they believe the humble plant can rise to meet. Easily, ABS-CBN News.